Yo, yo, what's going on, you guys? Your boy Devon Terrell, and welcome to another edition of this Help Me Devon Raw tutorial. And in this tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how to mix vocals like Drake, or for the lack of a better words, getting extremely close. Let's get right to it. So the beauty about this tutorial is I have the No Guidance with Chris Brown and Drake, and I have my version of No Guidance with myself with those vocals to compare it to. So I'm gonna play you Drake's, and then I'm gonna play you mine right after. Listen closely. Drake's first.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap, and your flex OD, your sex OD.
Mine.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap, and your flex OD.
Okay. Now, when you listen to that, sure, it's not exactly the same, but is it close? Yes, it is close. And I'm gonna show you how I got those vocals to sound close to Drake's. Let's just get right into it. Okay. So first thing first, what I'm gonna show you is my vocal chain. And that's pretty much all this is about. So now I'm looking at my vocal chain. I'm gonna show you my auto-tune settings, for instance. First things first, my auto-tune settings are, I like to use the Auto-Tune EFX 3, and the reason why is because to me it just has a better sound to it than the other auto-tunes. It sounds a lot more natural to me, and it's a lot easier to use. I won't get too deep in that, it's just something I highly recommend. So my auto-tune settings is a retune speed at around 25. Now 25 is something that you could use probably in all of the auto-tunes that you're probably using, so you can just keep that in mind. Run a 25 where you get a nice natural sounding auto-tune that's not like the super one that most hip-hop music is using obviously right now. It's a lot harder, but for me I like to use it at the 25 range just to clean up the vocal, nothing crazy. Obviously keys vary. Next thing that I like to do is we'll move right on over to my EQ. And the first thing I like to do with my EQ is I like to clean up. I like to get rid of the bad frequencies, the things that I don't like in the vocal. So first, let me just take all of this stuff off so that we could just solely hear what it's doing. And then we'll go from there. Okay, so this is the vocal by itself with the EQ, the subtractive EQ going on. Listen closely, I'll pop it back and forth.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap, and your flex OD, sex OD. You got it, girl, you got it.
Now, you'll hear a difference, and probably what you're really hearing is a loudness. You'll hear that when I have it bypassed that it sounds louder, and you hear when I have it engaged that it sounds quieter. Really, that's not what's going on. There's certain frequencies that are being resonated in the one that is bypassed that are not good, that I don't like, that are really muddy. I'm going to exaggerate this and show you it step by step. So let's go to this first band. Let me put myself in a good position. And I'll play this for you. So let's look at this one, this band one, which one is hitting around the 172 hertz range. I'm going to exaggerate this way up here and let you hear what's actually there. Listen closely.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap, and your flex OD, sex OD, you got.
Now, if you're listening in headphones or studio monitors, you can hear this. It feels like this holy kind of boxy kind of place. That's why I pull this out. And you may be asking, how did I find that frequency? Well, all I'm doing is I'm picking a frequency band and I'm sweeping. So I'll show you this right now. So let's crank this all the way back up. Let's move down to, let's say, way down here, and then let's sweep and see where we hear a problem. Listen closely.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap, and your flex OD, sex OD, you got it, girl, you got it.
And you can see once again, I found that spot and I'm taking it right out, and I'm taking around 3 to 4 dB of that out. Now, some people don't like to take that much out, but personally I do. I hate that sound. I want to get that boxiness out, so I take it out. So I took it out around the 3.7 hertz, dB range. I took about 3.7 dB out. Now, let's move on over to this frequency range, for instance. Let's move over to the 2 band that I have. And in the 2 band, I took out some in the 469 hertz range. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna exaggerate that. I'm gonna crank that and let you hear the AB between it. Listen closely.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap, and your flex OD, sex OD. You got it, girl, you got it.
took that stuff right out. It's nasty. I don't like it. Once again, it feels kind of hollow. I don't like that sound, and that's it. So basically, this is what you're going to do. You're going to continue to crank bands, sweep them, see the problem frequencies, and just take them out. I'll show you one more band that I had a problem with that I took out. Let's go to this 5 band. And this 5 band is the 2700 hertz range. So let's crank it way up. Listen.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, sex OD. You got it, girl. You got it. Whoa, let me tell you.
So I took that right out. And I took about, let's say, about 4 dB of that out. I completely don't like this frequency. This frequency is around that 3 kilohertz range. This is known as the pain frequency. Now, with all that said, obviously bypassing and without it, I've showed you the sound. The reason why I like to do this very early in the mixing of the vocal chain is because before I get to start boosting anything, I want to get rid of the stuff that I don't like. Make sense? So always try to use subtractive EQing first when you're mixing your vocals. Next thing that I moved on over to is a de-esser. Once again, getting rid of. I haven't boosted one EQ. All I'm doing is getting rid of before I start any compression, anything. I just want to get rid of all those problem frequencies before I run into them. So if you look right here, I got rid of the frequency 7100. That was the place that was giving me the most S's and hisses. I'll show you an A-B of that before and after. I'm going to pop it back and forth. Listen closely.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap, and your flex OD, sex OD.
One more time, I'll play it with and without it. So I'll play you this first track with it and then once without it.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap, and your flex OD, sex OD.
Without it.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap, and your flex OD, sex OD. You.
Big difference. So you hear those S's and T's really stand out and cut through the mix. And that's going to be a huge problem when you get to compression and other things and boosting and stuff like that. Moving right along. So next thing we're going to do is we're going to move on over to compression. Now, I went with the 1176. It has a little bit more of a thicker sound to me. It's a little bit warmer than the Blackie, which I'll show you if you don't know what that means. I use this plugin all the time. I love this compressor to start off with. And basically, I have a really, really slow attack, as you can see right here, and a very fast release. This is how I always like to set up my first compressor. I use multiple compressors. I don't just use one compressor. I use a few compressors, one after the other, in order to achieve the sound I like. So with this first compressor, I usually like to set a really slow attack time. I want those transients to cut through. I'm really trying to get that volume and level from the vocal and get some of the quieter parts louder and those louder parts a little quieter, just to kind of control my dynamics a little more. So I'll show you an A and B. It's going to be a huge difference. Listen closely.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap, and your flex OD, sex OD, you got it, girl, you got it.
So you hear a big difference between those quiet sounds and those louder sounds now, as far as them being extremely different. The quiet stuff is kind of matching up with the louder stuff, and now we have a more concise vocal, which is going to help me mix better going forward. Now imagine if I didn't do those subtractive EQing in the previous part, there would be so many problems in that vocal or so many things that would be boosted that it would be struggling to compress. Now I'm compressing more of the good stuff and not the bad stuff. Moving right along. Let's head on over to this EQ. Okay, and in this EQ, I'm taking out even more stuff and I'm boosting a little bit as well. So as you can see at the bottom hand, I'm rolling off up into the 146 hertz range. And when I listen to Drake's vocal, this is what I'm referencing off of. Remember, I keep going back and forth to Drake's vocal. And when I listen to his vocal, I noticed that a lot of the low end was rolled off. And I felt like in the 217 hertz range, there was some stuff pulled out as well. And that's where a lot of mud lives, which is a good place to start when you're trying to clear up a vocal. Instead of boosting the high end, just take out some of that low stuff. And a lot of that low stuff that you get the mud is a 217 hertz range. Okay. In here, you'll also see that I took out some of the 2000 hertz range as well. I just felt like it had a little bit too much presence. This is that range gives you a lot of presence. So sometimes if you feel like it's too overpowering to beat too much, you pull this down some. And then we just boosted the high end. I'm going to play you an A-B just so you can get an idea of what's going on. Listen closely. First with and then without.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap, and your flex OD, sex OD. You got it, girl, you got it. Whoa, let me tell you, you got it, girl, you got it.
So you can hear that it sounds a lot smoother when I have it, when I have this EQ engaged. A lot of the low end is rolled off. I boosted some of the high end so that it feels a little bit smoother. And then in the 2K range, I took some of that out because I felt like it was a little bit too much presence on the vocal when I'm trying to get it to sound like Drake's. Got me? Cool. Let's move right along. And just a heads up, I boosted in a 14 kilohertz range, and in the 7,000 hertz range. Got to be careful how you say that. Okay, moving right along. Next thing I do is I move right over to my C4. And what the C4 is just a multi-band compressor. So basically, all it's doing is, if you don't know, is I'm taking different sections of the vocal across the frequency spectrum and I'm compressing them different. So I can compress 400 hertz to 1,000 hertz different from how I compress 10,000 hertz to 18,000 hertz. That's all that's happening. So I'm just compressing different frequency bands how I want them. And all I'm doing using this is to even out the tone. So I'm looking for the right tone. So I'm going to play it for you before and after. So before.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, sex OD. You got it, girl, you got it. Whoa, let me tell you. You got it, girl, you got it.
So you can hear that it feels a lot more compressed. It feels a lot more punchy. It feels a lot more energetic. And this was me just using this to balance out the tone and get more energy from the vocal. I'll show you what I did. So from the 40 hertz range to the 588 hertz range, I compressed it pretty heavy. I'll show you before and after. So this is with it and without it. So with it.
Here's what you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap, and your flex OD, sex OD, you.
So you can hear the way that I compress it is, and the way I'm feeling it is, I compress it until it feels tight and it feels a lot smoother and better, where nothing is really poking out and jarring out at me. I try to get that low end part of my vocal really tight because I don't want that stuff to really jar out and poke out at me, especially when I'm comparing it to Drake's vocal. So that's why I have that compressed pretty tough on that one. The next band I move over to is a very small band, and it's the 588 hertz range to the 1,000 hertz range. A very, very short, short band, but it was very important to me. I'll let you hear just what it sounds like by itself with it on.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. Trips that you...
This is without it.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap, and your flex OD, sex OD, you got.
So you see, all I'm using that C4 for is just the C4-4, haha. C4-4 is for to balance out that tone, to really control those dynamics of those parts that I feel like are sticking out a little bit too much in the vocal. Okay, next part that I moved on to was this 1,000 hertz range all the way to the very top. So I'm gonna let you hear what it sounds like. Listen closely.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap, and your flex OD, sex OD, you.
So you can hear this thing is pretty bright when you listen to it by itself and it bypassed. But when you have it in, I'm using it to really control that part. Now, granted, if this was another day, I probably would take out even more high end on this. But for right now, for the sake of this tutorial, just know that I was doing this just to get to Drake. You understand what I'm saying? So I made this really, really tight. It's actually in the release of the high end. I don't like to have such a fast attack on the C4 band for this one, because I want those vocals to really cut through. Those transients are very important to me in the higher end of the vocal, where from 1,000 hertz and beyond, that's really a lot of the vocal. So I really try to back off on that when it comes to the attack. I put the release a lot slower. As you can see right here, this 183. The release is a lot slower in this band because I want those transients to pop through. So I use that to control that as well. So then we have this whole vocal like this.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap.
Cool. Moving on. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to add an RVox. And what this RVox is just a compressor slash limiter specifically created for a vocal. It's an amazing plugin. I think anyone that mixes vocals or anything, you should have this Waves plugin. It's amazing. It's not expensive. It's really, really good. Okay, and I'll show you just a simple before and after. It has two knobs, pretty simple to use. Bypass.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, sex OD. You got it, girl, you got it.
Just gives me a little bit more smoothness to that top end vocal. It takes a little bit of the bite away. Nonetheless, it just helps me take away some of those parts that are poking out a little bit more. It's used as a limiter. I have it right now compressing at about 60 dB, if I'm not mistaken. Look at it closely.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, sex OD, you got it, girl.
It even helps me attack those high-end kind of pieces that are kind of jarring out. It's a really, really good compressor slash limiter just designed for the vocal to help control those peaks and those pieces that are just kind of going above what you want. Next thing I did was added some more EQ. Now, in this EQ, I added some more high-end. Don't fight me. I'm going to show you later on how I actually combat this and get it to sound how I want it to sound, even though this is boosting some of the high end even more. So listen closely with and without it. So without it first.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, sex OD. You got it, girl, you got it. Whoa, let me tell you.
Cool, so I boosted some more to high end, and I also took out some more of what range? Of the 3 kHz range, which is known as that pain frequency that I just, I hate so much. So I took some more of that 3K frequency out, and I boosted some more of that high end frequency. And once again, this is me mixing to get vocals to sound similar to Drake in a sense, from what I'm hearing, okay? Next thing I did was I moved on over to another compressor. And on this compressor, this is what I like to do with my last compressor, which I believe is my last compressor. Yes. What I like to do with my last compressor is I really like to make the vocal tight. And what I mean, I like to make it tight. I like to make it tight where the vocal doesn't feel like it's moving as far as coming out of its pocket so much. I like the vocal to sound nice and tight, which Drake, for some reason, when they're mixing his vocals, always sounds like it's sitting in this nice one pocket, and it's just... it just works. No matter if he's quiet or loud, he's in the same pocket. So this is what this compressor really is. This is my compressor I always call for to be this extreme glue to my vocal. So listen closely to this vocal. I'll play it before and after.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, sex OD. You got it, girl, you got it.
So literally, this compressor is getting those peaks. It's taking those peaks, those last little bit of bitty pieces of those peaks, and it's bringing it down, and it's taking my quiet stuff and bringing it up. I got this compressor in around 3 dB, and that's it. So I just used about 3 compressors in unison with each other in different places. There, you don't take one compressor. Personally, I don't like to take one compressor and make it work so hard. I like to take multiple compressors and spread out the work. And now when I spread out the work, I can really continuously tame. So I just use 3 compressors, and this third compressor, my last one, is really to tame those peaks for the last time and really get the attack and release times the way I want it. So you can see right here, I have a pretty fast attack on it, which is somewhat unorthodox, but I'm going to show you how I bring some of those transients back in later on in this tutorial. And then I have a medium release so that I have those vocals kind of holding out a little longer to sound tighter in that pocket. So when you want something to sound a little tighter in the pocket, make the release a little slower. What does that mean? When you slow down the release, you're basically telling the compressor, hold the compression just a little longer as opposed to making it faster, where it'll just release that vocal constantly. Now I have the vocal doing like this. It's attacking and holding it for a while. Attacking, holding it for a while. So it feels like it sits in that pocket a little bit until the next line comes in. That's how I have this compressor set up. So it's a fast attack, relatively fast attack, and I have it on a medium release. And then you see I have a 3-to-1 ratio and just compressing at about 3 dB. Cool? Moving right along. Next thing I have going on is this SSL EQ. Now, once again, don't get intimidated by this EQ. You can use any EQ you want. I'm using it just to take some stuff out that I don't like. Okay, so I'm gonna play for you with and without, and then I'll explain what I have this EQ doing. So without first.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap, and your flex OD, sex OD. You got it, girl, you got it. Whoa, let me tell you, you got it, girl, you got it.
So if you listen to it closely, there's a huge difference in this now. It actually feels like there's a lot more clarity, and I took out a lot more of that muddiness that was in the vocal, and it sounds brighter. Now, I didn't boost anything. All I did was subtract. And sometimes, or excuse me, all the time, this is a great way to get more clarity in your vocal. Take out some frequencies. There are some frequencies at that low end place that if you take out will make your vocal sound brighter. Now I'm gonna show you what I did. So first thing I did was I moved over to the 300 hertz range and I took out about 3 dB of gain. And what that did was that freed up the vocal as far as that muddiness. It gave it a lot more clarity. Yes, it made it sound slightly thinner, but nonetheless, it made the vocal cut through the mix. One thing you have to do, and what I'm not doing in this tutorial is, I'm not showing you it with the beat. So if I played you the beat back, and then I took out that 3 dB range, you'll notice a huge difference in the clarity of the vocal, which now I'll play with the beat so you can hear the difference. Okay. So I'll keep popping this plugin on and off and letting you hear it. So with that, without first. And you're looking for the clarity and the cut of the vocal.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, sex OD. You got it, girl, you got it.
One more time, listen closely.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap.
So don't listen to the volume of the vocal. Don't be fooled by that. Listen to how the vocal is cutting through that mix. Now, when I have it bypassed, it's not cutting through as strong. It's louder, of course, but it's not cutting through as much. But when I have this EQ engaged, you'll hear the vocal cutting through a little bit more. Now, also what I'm doing in this EQ is, that you're not realizing, is I am also taking out some of that presence again. And the reason why I'm taking out some of that presence again, in this one, I'm taking it out at the 1.57 kilohertz range. The reason why I'm taking it out there is because when I compared it to Drake's version and no guidance, I still felt like I had a little bit too much presence on the vocal. So I'm really pulling back that presence on the vocal. And what this is going to actually do is, and I notice this with a lot of Drake's vocals, is it's going to have the fatigue that you usually feel on your ears from vocals. It's going to disappear. It's going to be less. And the reason why is because that's the frequency range that makes people's, that give people the air fatigue and things like that. And I noticed that in Drake's vocals, he takes out a good amount of that so that that vocal just feels like it rides, and it's like an instrument. It's a beautiful little trick. But that 3 kilohertz range, guys, that 1 to 3 kilohertz range is a powerful frequency range that a lot of vocals, personally, I like to pull back just a little bit so that I can have a listener listen a little longer to the vocals. A little trick that he does, and I'm noticing it. So granted, in this EQ, what I could have done was I could have turned up the output on it just a little bit more, just to match what it, the volume of what it sounded like. But I can hear it from my ears and my experience. I knew, oh man, it's cutting right through the mix a lot better now, and there's more clarity. So just for the sake of that in volume, just don't be fooled by the volume. Okay, next thing I'm gonna move on over to is analog saturation. And I cannot stress to you how important this is, and how much I always say how important this is. So long story short, all I do is I turn this bad boy on and I pick what setting I want. For this setting, I only use the warm tape. I literally didn't move a knob. I just throw this thing on and it sounds amazing. I highly recommend this plugin. So bypass, I'll listen to you with before and after. Listen closely.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, sex OD, you got it, girl.
Let's play it by itself. Listen closely without it.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, sex OD, you got it, girl, you got it.
And you can hear it. It sounds like the high ends feel a lot more brilliant and more smooth. The presence on it just kind of rise. It just feels better. It just feels like the whole vocal just was sent through something amazing and dope. And this is analog saturation at its best. Smoothing out and rounding out those peaks to give you a more analog sounding vocal. And I love this. And literally this is me just slapping on the warm tape preset and not turning up a knob. Now granted, you can mess around with this a little bit more, but I always highly recommend using analog saturation for your vocals or for anything in mixing, since you're mixing in a digital box like this with just plugins. Okay, last plugin that I'm using on this chain is It was very small things. So you can see right here that I brought in a little bit of the presence as far as the lower mid range frequencies. You see I brought up that 2000 hertz range and that 1000 hertz range just to give it a little bit bump probably in warmth. And then once again, I brought down the entire kind of bright, brilliant presence frequencies because I probably felt like it was just a little bit too much and I just was compensating for when I listened and bypass and listened to Drake stuff. So I'll play it for you before and after just so you can hear that final EQ.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap and your flex OD, sex OD, you got it, girl, you got it.
So to my ears, when I hear it, I can tell that I use this EQ to smooth out that vocal just a little bit more. I can tell that this 6-band EQ that I use right here, I took out about 1 dB at the 5,000 hertz range, helped a lot. That really helped smooth out those highs just a little bit more to make them a little bit more understandable and just smoother for the listener. So that's very important. And that's that. One thing I don't want you guys to be discouraged about that I know a lot of you guys say, and I heard you say this in previous tutorials, is you look at how many plugins I have here and you say, wow, that's a lot of plugins. And you wonder how I'm able to use this many plugins without my computer hiccuping and going crazy. Well, guess what? If you look closely at my vocal chain, this is not a lot. You see one compressor, you see two compressors, you see a multiband, you see three compressors, and literally count the EQs. One, two, and three. These things don't take up a lot of DSP. These are just EQs. These are not really a lot of plugins. These are just EQs and compressors. I'm not using a bunch of bells and whistles. I use three compressors and I use three EQs. That's basically the premise of what I've used. So don't be discouraged about how many plugins are there. If you can figure it out in two EQs, sure, do that. But as you're going and mixing, you might have liked what you did in that EQ, but you just want to tweak something at the other stage of it to kind of mask or fix some things. So don't be discouraged at how many plugins you see. Use these plugins how you feel is best for your workflow. Me, I like to mix as I go. So as I'm mixing, I'm like, okay, this sounds good. Oh, it needs some more compression here. This is good. I EQ before, but oh, I just need a little bit more out of it. That's my workflow and that's how I like to work. So don't be discouraged by how many EQs you see. Okay, last but not least, we're gonna move over to the effects. We're gonna make this very short and sweet. So first thing I like to do is I like to add a long reverb, which is self-explanatory. Listen closely, I'll play it for you with and without.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, sex OD, you got.
Okay, great. You can hear that right there. I'll show you what reverb I'm using. I'm using this vintage reverb from Valhalla, which I love. It's my favorite reverb, I'm not gonna lie, at the moment. I'm using a 70s sound. You can see my presets in the whole nine. A very short pre-delay of 21 milliseconds. All you're doing is, I like to set my pre-delays pretty short, and the reason why is because all the pre-delay is asking you how long before the vocal first comes in do you want me to engage the reverb. So I told it 21 milliseconds. Now I have a tutorial on how I like to come up with the calculations for that. I'll put that in the description below of how to calculate your reverb times. You can check it over there. That's a pretty long one. Next one I like to do is I like to add this eighth note delay, and all this eighth note delay is, it gives my vocal a little bit more sense of a movement, and then I listen to Drake's version and I can notice he has a tad bit of it too. So listen closely to this eighth note delay. I'll play it with and without.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, sex OD, you got it.
Cool. So the eighth note delay is there and it adds a little bit more of a little bounce. It sounds great. I love that. Next thing I do is I add this short verb. Now, the short verb is actually not a short verb, it's actually a plate verb. And I like plate verbs because it gives me a little bit more of a volume and it actually gives me a little bit more of a space, kind of a, it gives my vocal a little bit more of a texture, if that makes any sense. And I like to do this, and I notice Drake has this on a lot of his vocals, a lot of plate verbs. Listen closely, before and after.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week.
Better yet, I'll play it without the long verb in the eighth note so you can hear exactly what it's doing solely by itself. Listen closely. With.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, sex OD, you got it, girl, you got it.
So I hear a major difference with that. I can actually hear like the vocal actually lives in a space. Like it feels like it's in some sort of chamber slash that's what the plate verb is doing. So that gives a little bit more texture to your vocal that you didn't even know was there. Powerful trick that's coming up next is this doubler. This is something that I had to play with a lot to figure out how to kind of get close to Drake's vocal, because he always seems to have this vocal that is, obviously it's a single a signal right here, but I always felt like he had such a stereo vocal, like it felt like there was a lot of whiff on it. So what did I do? I tried this technique. I used a doubler, and I used this preset right here. And if you look closely, I want you to take a screenshot of this preset, etc. This is the settings that I came up with that got pretty close. So on one vocal, I used 9.4 in the delay, and on the second one, I used 23.7 for the delay. And then the gain is -6 on the first one, and the second one, detune on the first one is 6, detune on the second one is -6. You can screenshot this. You can press pause in this video and see these settings. Listen closely what it's doing. I'll take everything off so you can hear what it's exactly doing. So without first.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, sex OD. You got it, girl, you got it. Whoa, let me tell you. You got it, girl, you got it.
So right now what I'm going to do is I'm going to exaggerate it so you can hear even more what it's doing. So I have it at 19.7 is where I kind of stuck with, -19.7. But I'll show you what it sounds like exaggerated so you can see exactly what it's doing. So without it, and then I'll crank it. Listen closely.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, sex OD, you got.
So obviously that was an exaggerative example of what it's doing, but if you listen closely, it's literally taking that center vocal, copying it, and adding it to the stereo field and bringing that bad boy up. So I love this because now it gives a sense of a stereo lead vocal, and I noticed that a lot with Drake's vocals, and that thing works and kills. So listen to this closely one time so far what we have.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, sex OD. You got it, girl, you got it.
Cool, so that's what we have so far. Now, last but certainly not least is this thing right here. And this is the most important thing to me, I'm gonna be honest with you. And this is my parallel compressor, something that a lot of people are not using. And I laugh because this is exactly what you're probably missing 90% of the time. So what I'm doing is I have this vocal and I'm sending a copy of this vocal out to a send. Now on the send, I'm going to have a vocal affected, the same vocal that I have on the lead, and I'm going to compress it the crap out of it. Like, I'm going to literally make this thing dynamic list. There's going to be no dynamics on this vocal. It's going to be literally a ball of audio. And I'm going to take that and I'm going to blend that with the original vocal. So it's going to be this crushed vocal that's going to add this great bottom middle piece that you're not even gonna realize that wasn't even there, but it's gonna sound so much better. So I'll play it for you with and without it, and then you tell me if you hear a difference. So without it first, and I'll keep popping it back and forth. Listen close.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap.
Better yet, I'll play it without the beat so you can hear the difference. Listen closely. Without first.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, sex OD. You got it, girl, you got it. Whoa, let me tell you. You got it, girl, you got it. Yeah, you should deal with a 5-star nigga. Know you were more than just 6 figures. I'm applying the pressure, my finger on the trigger. I know you got a roster just full of hitters.
So you can hear that in that lower mid frequency, there's this stronger presence in the vocal without disrupting the original vocal. And that's why I feel like this is extremely powerful. So that's what this parallel compressor is doing. Settings. Gotcha. No problem. You look at my 1176. As opposed to how I had it set in the other one, what I'm doing is I'm smashing the crap out of this vocal. You can see right here.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week.
I press the all function on my compressor, and all the all function is it's telling it to make it a 50-to-1 ratio. Basically, that's a limiter. That's all that is. It's making it a 50-to-1 ratio, and I'm smashing it about -10 dB of gain reduction that I'm smashing this vocal. So this is a vocal that you're trying to smash. I have the attack cranked all the way to the fastest setting and the release to the middle. It's holding that compression. It's literally making a ball of audio. Next thing I'm doing is I'm using a limiter to control the peaks of that a little bit. Look closely.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap.
So it's literally controlling those peaks. I don't want any dynamics on this vocal. I'm trying to smash this vocal, okay? That's the whole point of this. Next thing I have is I'm rolling off a little bit of the low end so that I don't use that and combine that with the original vocal because I don't want that boominess in the vocal. So I roll off some of that low end, which you can see right here, simple EQ. And then I'm taking out some of that 1 to 0.3 kilohertz range. And the reason why is because I noticed when I'm comparing those vocals, I don't want so much presence on my vocals. So that's why I'm taking out some of that stuff. Not much, 2.6 dB, basically 3 dB. And I'm taking that and I'm combining that with his vocal, excuse me, with my vocal. And that's how that's done. So I'll let you hear this one more time. I'll play a little bit of mine. I'll play a little bit of Drake's and you can hear what we have. So Drake's first.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, your sex OD.
Mine.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, your sex OD.
Okay. So if you listen to that, you have a vocal that is close to Drake's. Is it the same as Drake's? Of course not. When it comes to things that he recorded this with, when it comes to his vocal texture, etc., of course, it's going to sound different. But nonetheless, can we get close? Yes. That is a vocal that I felt like was pretty close to Drake's as far as for my type of vocal. And I feel like if you use these techniques and these techniques, you can get close as well. Now, I want you to comment, like, subscribe to Help Me Devon. Hit us on the Instagram at Help Me Devon for more questions. If you guys have any questions about this tutorial, please feel free to email me or comment below. HelpMeDevon@gmail.com and let me know what you guys want to see next. That was a tutorial on how to mix vocals like Drake. I hope you enjoyed it. Until next time.